Genesis chapter 4. Now, the man had relations with his wife, Eve, and she conceived and gave birth to Cain. And she said, I have gotten a man-child with the help of the Lord. Again, she gave birth to his brother, Abel. And Abel was a keeper of the flocks, but Cain was a tiller of the ground. So it came about in the course of time that Cain brought an offering to the Lord of fruit of the ground. Abel, on his part, also brought the firstlings of his flock and of their fat portions. And the Lord had regard for Abel and for his offering, but for Cain and for his offering, he had no regard. So Cain became very angry, and his countenance fell. Then the Lord said to Cain, Why are you angry, and why has your countenance fallen? If you do well, will not your countenance be lifted up? And if you do not do well, sin is crouching at the door, and its desire is for you, but you must master it. Cain told Abel his brother, and it came about when they were in the field that Cain rose up against Abel his brother and killed him. Then the Lord said to Cain, Where is Abel your brother? And he said, I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper? And he said, What have you done? The voice of your brother's blood is crying to me from the ground. Now you are cursed from the ground, which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you cultivate the ground, it will no longer yield its strength to you. You will be a vagrant and a wanderer on the earth. Cain said to the Lord, My punishment is too great to bear. Behold, you have driven me this day from the face of the ground, and from your face I will be hidden, and I will be a vagrant and a wanderer on the earth, and whomever finds me will kill me. And the Lord said to him, Therefore, whoever kills Cain, vengeance will be taken upon him sevenfold. And the Lord appointed a sign for Cain, so that no one finding him would slay him. Then Cain went out from the presence of the Lord and settled in the land of Nod, east of Eden. Cain had relations with his wife, and she conceived and gave birth to Enoch. And he built a city, and called the name of the city Enoch after his son. Now Enoch was born to Irad, and Irad became the father of Mehujael. And Mehujael became the father to Methuselah, and Methuselah became the father of Lamech. Lamech took himself two wives. The name of one was Adah, and the name of the other was Zillah. Adah gave birth to Jabal. He was the father of those who dwell in tents and have livestock. His brother's name was Jubal. He was the father of those who play the lyre and the pipe. As for Zillah, she gave birth to Tubal-Cain, the forger of all implements of bronze and iron. And the sister of Tubal-Cain was Naamah. Lamech said to his wives, Adah and Zillah, listen to my voice. You wives of Lamech, give heed to my speech, for I have killed a man for wounding me, and a boy for striking me. If Cain is avenged sevenfold, then Lamech 77-fold. Adam had relations with his wife again, and she gave birth to a son named Seth. For she said, God has appointed me another offspring in place of Abel, for Cain killed him. To Seth, to him also a son was born, and he called his name Enosh. Then men began to call upon the name of the Lord. What did you think of that chapter? What did you think of chapter 4?
Cain killed Abel.
That sounds right.
And then,
I'm sorry. Yes, that's true.
And then why did God not like Cain, like plants that he gave him?
So that's a really interesting question. It's a really good question. I've thought about that question since I was about your age. You know, because there is that thought, okay, they're both bringing what they perceive to be the best. And God is happy with Abel, but not with Cain, right?
Yeah.
And so Cain, and that's kind of the trick of life. Oftentimes you will think you're giving your best of something, but maybe there's more you could do. Maybe it's not quite your best. Maybe you need to take a moment and actually consider, am I actually doing good? Because, you know, God even says to Cain, if you try to do well, won't your countenance rise? Like, just in you actually trying to do well, wouldn't your countenance go up? But what does Cain decide to do? Yeah, that's right, isn't it? It's almost that simple. He kind of doesn't take God's advice to just try and do well. He exists in some place where he goes, well, if my brother wasn't alive, I'd be doing better. So he's sent away. He's not allowed to live where, you know, where his mother Eve and where his father Adam and where Abel have made a home. And he's kind of sent off to the east. And he makes these makers of war and bronze, and his great grandson ends up becoming this person who says, I've killed two people and one of them's a child. You know, like, I'm basically a person who's okay with killing a child for looking at me wrong.
Why did he kill them?
And that's also not quite clear, but it is clear that it's saying murdering and existing in a place with murder is going to beget and create more murder. It's going to create eventually a culture that just kind of goes, whatever, I killed a kid.
But back then, did people live a lot?
So far as, I mean... There might be two things that are true there. Yeah, it's possible that you might have had kids when you were a bit younger, and it's also possible that people lived a lot longer. If you have people who are living like 800, 900 years, very, very different life than when you think of what we have, maybe like 70 or 80 years.
Yeah, and like the longest, maybe 100.
Sure. What did you like about that chapter?
Can I talk?
Yes, you may talk, yes.
Everything is beautiful. Squash banana.
Everything is beautiful. Duka duka squash banana. All right, that was chapter 4 of Genesis. We'll be back tomorrow with chapter 5. Say goodbye. Say bye bye.
Bye bye.
Bye bye, camera.
Bye bye.
All right, go ahead, hit stop recording. Go ahead, hit stop recording.